Hello for Thursday, August 28th. This is the Dow 60-minute chart. On Wednesday, you can see the little dip here, a little V-shaped dip below the 50-period EMA, but it still stayed 45 points above the support. If you're watching on the pivot points, we're watching on the futures, it did drop below. It went quickly, so the sell-off in the morning was very quick, and it went right to it. First, it just paused just for a moment at support one, and then it started down to support two. It didn't get close to it. It didn't get that far. And then when it stabilized, moved up a little bit, up to the pivot, then dropped back down, and finally moved back on up. It just shows it how anxious people are in to get in this market. I bet the bears were thinking, boy, now we've hit the top of the market, and things are going to go down. But it's very strong, and don't expect the market just to die all of a sudden. Anyway, we came back up close to highs. As you can see, the former high was 9619. We got up to 9609. Actually, the high was 96. What was the high? I don't have it here. It doesn't show. Anyway, got up close to it and closed down a little bit above it. So remember, next week is going to be also a slow week as far as volume-wise in front of the holiday, and then after the holiday, it's generally it's historically a plus week. So it could be after these next 2 weeks where we see some more, some bigger action, but could happen really anytime. Wait, so with this dip, it flushed out a lot of the sellers, and maybe we have a chance to make new highs even on Friday. So we'll see. Those are areas to watch on the upside, and you can see the SPX. This is a 60-minute chart. Looks like the same as the last 2 days, nothing to say. It stayed right in the same area here, so you can see where the upside is. And we've been saying it's possible to make new highs, go up to the 1050. Obviously, it could go a lot higher, but this is what the Fibonacci says, it could be a pullback. If it's getting close to breaking through this downside, even by going sideways. And if it does, it doesn't mean it doesn't count, but it's just kind of a chicken way to do it. We hope that it moves on up and stays in this range at least one more day, then we don't have to talk about it. Okay, now get look to the Russell. We didn't even add any lines here. Also had a V dip, about the same. It was a little bit above, if we draw the line, just a hair above where this gap was even, and that should be support, the top of the gap first and then the bottom of the gap once it fills. If it fills, it will at some point. Right now, this is now support 572 and resistance at the 588 level. Those are areas to watch, and you can see the RSI had gone down a bit, moved back up. And Stochastic did make it all the way under 20. That was a good sign, meaning that it could move up. MACD has not yet crossed over. Histogram has not gone positive, but if those happen, then we're going to see some more on the upside. And if we look at the Toronto Stock Exchange, you can see it's also a little dip down to its 50-period EMA on this 60-minute chart. Came back up, didn't make new highs, but it may give that a try. Okay, we'll show a couple of mechanical trades because in the morning sell-off, you can see on the FAZ, this did have a... Actually, let me look here. This one didn't have, because this had the crossover was the day before. That's why I'm a bit confused. Here we had the sell signal that came in about 1:30, right at this point, somewhere down in here, about 23:40, a little bit above it, around 23:50 area. And of course, it made about 50 cents selling that at the end of the day. So FAZ did work out. And what I'm talking about is SRS. And SRS also had a sell signal, as you can see, also about the same time of the day, and it came in at around, if you figure this line here was, we're about this area, so somewhere around 1165, right about, a little bit below that where we have this red line. It depends on how quick you react to it, and it also closed at 1128, so there was some profit in that. As you can see in the past, we've had some whipsaws like over here. This was the day before when it had both a buy and a sell at the same price. So this time it did make up gains, and so did FAZ, which the day before also was like basically a break even. So that's what happens with these. But overall, they do really nicely. Okay, on other trades that happened during the day, this was interesting because this kind of echoes the market. HMA, which has been toying around in this area, not able to break above it. Still didn't do very much, but we'll take it off the list finally. Market, we didn't mark it because we thought we'd get another day. Look it out, dropped down at low, 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 and then it shot right back up. Now this was quick, as you can see. It dropped down, then came right back up again. And that's like, we like to call that a rinse job, because what it did on the way down is it got rid of all the sellers. And then there was no more sellers, and so the buyers had an easy move back up and look at increased volume as it was. So maybe this will finally continue. That's basically what happened with the market as well. It dipped down, then the buyers came in. So maybe now there's no more sellers, at least for the short term. Sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't. When you see these big sell-offs and come up, see, that happened on this day. This ran down, and then it came up, and then it moved up for a few days. So HMA, possible, it will do that some more. Other breakouts that were more clean and simple was COL. As you can see, it was open just a little bit below the breakout point, then hit the breakout point, and then ran up really nicely, closed up nicely for the day. And also Ryan. Now, Ryan had a couple levels, and so we're showing that for two reasons. One, it hit this first level here at 42.30. We had 42.30, 42.90. It got up to 42.89 and didn't break above it. So if you buy the lows and you don't think it's going over, you can take some of your profits. So we got in okay. I've made that 60 cent move in there. You can take off some of your profits, and then if it breaks out, fine. You could also treat it as a new entry above 42.90 and buy it at that point. So that's why we're showing it's a possibility of a new buy if you missed it in the day, particularly if it goes sideways for a day, but the market springs back, that might be okay. Now, Lazy Boy, LZB, over 978. Looks like now this is a topside trade. You'll have to look at a close-term chart, see if you want to buy a little lower. This is where the shadow high was there. Volume's about average. This also had a little bit of a rinse job. It dipped down with the market. And then once people realize that the market isn't going to roll over, boy, they jumped right back in it. It went back up, so Lazy Boy may have some upside on it. VMED, V-M-E-D, this is one. This is why we showed the HMA as well. VMED is one we posted intraday before it got to this first level buy. And so we hoped it didn't get at least two, because we wanted to use it for today as well. But it did make its first level buy over here, moved up all right from there. And so the next level is above this 1182 on VMED, and it had increased volume, so this looks like it has a good possibility of continuing as well. EGLE, look, this had nice volume, more than double its normal volume, 4.2 million shares, and it ran right into that resistance, a 50-day EMA, and you look left, it was also resistance from this other candle here. So it'd be real nice if it goes sideways first. But if momentum, like there's been a lot of momentum stocks, maybe this will just go right ahead. In this case, over 538, good volume would be a good sign. And it did have good volume once, so maybe it will continue. Look over here when it had good volume. It ran up for several days. This could be a repeat at least for a couple days on EAGL. And I'm sorry, EGLE. Don't want to mix those two up. Okay, ATI over $31.34. This is already above its 50-day, so now we're going over here, and at least it'd be like $1.30 just to get to the up to the 200-day. And if you look left, that's our long red candle, so it's good chances if it breaks here that it will get up to that 200-day, especially with that volume that was behind it before. Then we've got just a couple more we want to mention, and we don't have exact prices on these, and this is why. These are just ones that look like interesting momentum plays. Big volume for this stock when it ran up this day, then lower volume as it pulled back, and then even much lower for 2 days, and it stayed above the 200-day. That was a good entry on a Thursday, of course, but had good volume, so good chances that it, well, I shouldn't say it that way. Well, actually, I think it is okay to say. I think it's good chances they're going to try this high once again. Anyway, I pointed out we don't give any exact price. You just watch it if you like to play momentum plays. TGIC somewhere in here could give you a decent day trade. Also, you've got BNE. This is one we're ready to put on the list underneath this yellow line, and it closed near its high of day, and it broke out. We had this before the close, and it broke out. It was already up 7%, but it wasn't fantastic volume. This has got these long red candles, so if it goes pulls back or goes sideways, it'd be a better chance that the next time it will make some more significant gains, perhaps that, but we do need more volume on that. So those are the additions for this Friday as we head into the weekend. It's summertime, so I hope you have a really nice weekend. Want to thank you for coming by the site this week and in the chat room and so forth. We have a newsletter coming out. It's free. Just sign up on the homepage and we'll give that out to you. And also, sometime on Sunday night, we'll have a new video for Monday. So we'll see you then. Enjoy yourself. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.